Yeah, my big dream is the Tour de France.
To take on the biggest teams in the world, how far could we go with African riders?
From South Africa, first African team in the Tour de France, MTN-Qhubeka.
A bicycle can change somebody's life, you know? I mean, like, it has changed my life.
If we can develop that hero, that African hero on a bicycle, to dream and not just sit at home and wait for things to happen, that's the power of the bicycle.
Tour de France is not an event you hear much about in the daily life of Africa. The sport is expensive, bikes few and far between. It's a challenge to fix an inner tube, let alone buy cycling Lycra.
Njewe mukuri mvuka navutse mu muryango w'abana basanga 9 nkaba ndu umwana wanyuma wavutse mu rugo.
Cyclist Adrian Niyashuti grew up in Rwanda, a country scarred by one of the greatest human atrocities in living memory. Adrian is Tutsi, and he's a genocide survivor. Adrian lost 6 brothers in the 1994 genocide, killed by Hutu neighbours in their village. 1 million people died. 7-year-old Adrian escaped death by hiding between 2 mattresses. Sport is not only in his future dreams, it's also a huge part of his past.
Imana ikinga akaboko tuza kurokoka aho ndi umuntu utwara amagare maze kumenyekana mu Rwanda.
At a wooden bike classic, Adrian won the mountain bike race at 19, his first big break into cycling.
Uwo munsi sinzabibagirwa mu buzima bwanjye, ndanawutsinda bampa igihembo cy'igare, aribwo bwa mbere nari mbonye igare mukuri nyirizina rishyashya.
Winning that race in 2006 led to the London Olympics.
Rwanda, 7 competitors, 3 athletes, 1 cyclist, mountain biker.
Not only was Adrian the first Rwandan mountain bike rider in history, he also carried the flag and the hopes of a nation. Cycling as a sport has grown in Africa. Adrian joined Team Rwanda in 2007, their first national cycling team. It's incredible to see, more than 2 decades after the genocide, a cycling team with both Tutsi and Hutu riders together.
Umukino w'amagare mukuru ni umukino mwiza kandi umukino ukomeye. Ni umukino usaba ubwitange. Ni umukino usaba nta mpamvu yo gukomeza kurangwa n'amacakubiri. Abanyarwanda turi umwe.
Though the Tour de France started as a cycling race to sell a magazine in 1903, the event has become an unlikely way to help rebuild a destroyed nation.
Ariko aho tugeze tugomba kugira ubumwe n'ubwiyunge kandi tukareba ejo hazaza kurenza gukomeza guta igihe kubyarangiye ahubwo tukigira kubyarangiye kubona futura y'ejo hazaza.
Adrian caught the attention of Doug Ryder, a former South African cycling champion. He founded the first African team 8 years ago, MTN-Qhubeka, the Zulu word for moving forward or progress. His dream was to take the first African cycling team to the Tour de France.
If Africa can develop the best endurance runners in the world, why not cyclists? So if we could put a cycling team together to take on the biggest teams in the world, you know, how far could we go with African riders?
I lost my mom when I was 8 years old, and my father when I was 13 years old. My aunt, she took me from the site, and my mom passed away. She took care of me. She was always there for me.
In South Africa, Songizo Jim is rarely seen without his cycling Lycra. He was 14 years old when he saw a cycling tour stream past his township.
I was watching the race. You know, some things, they happen, but you don't know what the reason it happens for. But for me to be at the moment, I told my friends I'm going to do cycling. But at that time, I didn't even know how to ride a bicycle.
It only took Songizo a couple of weeks to learn how to pedal, and a year later, he was riding in that same race.
It's like I came to a place where I belong. For me, there's nothing else that I want to do than just riding my bike.
The Songizo Jim started cycling at 14, and at 23 was racing in the World Tour. A rider that only saw cycling at the age of 14. For most sports, that's already way too late to get into it and to become a professional, because it takes years and years and years of refining your body to be able to do a sport. And for him, you know, he's now racing at the highest level.
Songizo joined Doug Ryder's African team, MTN-Qhubeka, in 2012.
You get to travel all over the world, you meet people, you learn more about other people's cultures. It's like a university of life.
Songizo was always very clear about his cycling dreams, though his chosen sport was an unusual decision to friends and family.
The most popular sport in South Africa is football. In my neighborhood, when I started, people thought I was going crazy. You know, you're wearing tights, you know, all this. I mean, like also for my aunt also, she was like, you must stop this cycling thing.
Ngelo xesha kwakunzima kakhulu, ewe kwakunzima kakhulu. Ngoba kwakufuneke apheke endlini xa ndiphangeleyo ajonge nomntana ngoba nam nomntana. Ya kwakunzima kuye enyanisweni because.
Now people, they can see now who am I today, and they can see what I was doing all along. Now they don't think I'm going mad.
So we are trying again, ngokuba makazame apha community so bakwazi ufumana bakwazi ukuba nayicycling. Abantwana abaninzi apha community banomnqweno kakhulu ufana naye because ba.
Helmet ifako hashtag. Leyo itele ukuthini?
Simpondo.
Simpondo? Then uyinkomo?
Number one.
Uresele number one, ka wena. Ayikho enye iposition. Ingaphi unyaka? 11. Ngokuyifana nempondo.
Tour de France is dominated by European countries like France, Spain and Belgium.
It's very difficult for an African to take on cycling because unlike athletics, unlike running, it's an expensive sport to get into. The Ethiopians, the Kenyans, the Tanzanians, the black runners from Africa, they've enjoyed a lot of success down the years, and I think the simple reason is because running, it's very cheap. All you need is a pair of shorts and some running shoes.
Just that 5%, that 10%.
2 years ago, the African team went professional and moved their training base from South Africa to Europe. Just before they were due to leave, Adrian was diagnosed with a dangerous blood clot and left behind. He was forced off the road and could only train indoors.
I mean, the dedication and the commitment, I would have cracked.
Kuko igihe cyose nubaha akazi kanjye kandi nkakunda, numvaga guhita ngira nko gucika imbaraga bitari muri njyewe.
He missed a year in his progression in this team when we went to Europe for the first time, and it was a big learning curve and a big opportunity that Adrian missed.
Meanwhile, the move to Europe started paying off. The unknown African team started getting noticed in the spring of 2013. For South African Songizo, this was going to be a significant class in his university of life.
There was never a South African rider of colour that had ever been in a World Tour race before, and it was massive for him, massive for South Africa, and it was a big door opener.
Gizo Jim is ready for me.
It was spring, but winter unseasonably showed up. Songizo's big opportunity looked like it may be seriously jeopardised.
That year it was raining, snowing. It was really, really, like, that's the coldest day I've ever had in my life.
Cycling is like no other sport. You have to face the elements.
When things get really tough, you know, think about where you come from. I've came such a long way. So many people that are looking up at you. So now, if you're going to give up, that means you're failing everybody.
The temperatures in Songizo's hometown rarely drop below 7 degrees Celsius in winter. This race has even the most seasoned riders pulling out with hypothermia.
Non secure there.
So the rider struggling a bit with a muscle.
Up against snow, sleet, and the strongest teams in the Continental Tour, the African team surprises everyone.
He kicks it off in a big way. Here comes Gerald Gielek of the MTN-Qhubeka team. Who's going to get it? And it looks as if Gielek just about has the legs as they go to the line. It's almost a blind, but there's no doubt about who got the win. And that was Gerald Gielek of the MTN-Qhubeka team, already making a wonderful, wonderful impression on World Tour racing.
Against the odds, a Team Africa rider wins the race.
That day was really crazy. I mean, like, for us, the goal was to come top 10. And to win, it was just unbelievable.
That's when I and many others who follow the world of cycling realised, hey, we've got an African team in our midst and there to enjoy success.
For Team Africa, cycling isn't just about success in sport. In Songizo's home nation of South Africa, 8 million children have no choice but to walk to school every day.
Bicycles are, you know, to be mobile and makes you entrepreneurial. It gives you access to things that you didn't even know existed, access to healthcare, access to education, access to a job, to economic opportunity.
As well as trying to get Africa to the Tour de France, Doug Ryder established a charity side of the team. Together with World Bicycle Relief, they give bikes away in exchange for growing trees and picking up rubbish in their communities.
You know, we wanted to show what was possible from the African continent. So we're leveraging the success of our professional team to generate funds to buy bicycles for communities across Africa, for them to realize their dreams, be it to get from here to school or to become the next future Tour de France champion.
A bicycle can change somebody's life, no? I mean, like, it has changed my life. And there are kids here waiting to get bikes also so I can try to change their life.
Cycling is growing in Africa. Countries like Rwanda even have their own tour. After 10 months on a stationary bicycle, Adrian can finally compete again. Tour di Rwanda would be his first race since his blood clot recovery.
We're here to see Adrian's mum, so we're just going to have a quick picture with her and then, looking good.
Seeing him come back the way he does, I didn't think it was capable of coming back at such a high level so quickly after the problems he's had.
Adrian's story as a survivor has left a mark on his African team.
Sometimes when you travel with sports, it's a little far removed from reality because you're in a different city every day, but ultimately we are in Rwanda and Rwanda's got a very significant history.
Adrian is a big part of our lives. He's touched all of us on the team.
Very privileged for me to be able to come with Adrian, hear his story and relate what he went through and his family and how the country's grown from there.
You have to fight for, remember yourself, your family. It's hard to sleep and survive your life.
Adrian doesn't win, but the race creates a huge buzz on the roads of Rwanda. Daniel's dream couldn't have been more impossible.
Daniel Teklahamanot from Eritrea was probably the pioneer of African cycling. When there was no African riders really in Europe at all, he started to race in France and Switzerland as an amateur.
The flow of Eritrean refugees has meant governments around Europe were not prepared to issue Daniel a visa. In 1 year, he missed 26 races, all because of visa complications.
It's a shame that he couldn't continue his career at Orica Green Edge. The team wanted him to stay, but because of visa issues, they couldn't commit to his services long term.
Fortunately, Italy was prepared to let Daniel train there, so he moved to the town of Lucca.
Daniel's doing really well. It's nice to have him in the breakaway, and it was part of our plan today to get a rider in the early breakaway.
Daniel has integrated incredibly well into the team and the other riders, understanding the struggles that he's had to be a professional cyclist. They never had the challenges of leaving your family for 7 months, of staying in someone's basement in Europe to try and make it happen.
Cycling is really suffering. If you want to ride, you must know what is happening.
MTN-Qhubeka is 70% African.
Just go.
Doug Ryder brought in a range of international talent to help mentor the African cyclists and qualify for the big races.
Okay, thank you.
And if we want to win, then it's today the only chance, yeah?
I really like that mentality of, you know, a team of guys that's out with for something to prove, you know. They want to take on the world, and I really like that. I think that brings the best out of everyone.
Abantu bo muri Europe, mpamvu badusize ni mpamvu badutsinda, atari uko baturusha imbaraga, atari uko baturusha, ahubwo uko baturusha skills.
After 2 years on the professional circuit, the mentoring program has finally paid off. They're invited as a wildcard entry to compete in the race of their dreams, the Tour de France.
I'll never forget that day. I actually was speechless. In fact, I wasn't even breathing. And I was like, oh my goodness, this is just unbelievable.
With 23 riders in the team, only a handful will make the cut.
The selection for the Tour de France wasn't easy. We have 23 riders that have all incredible abilities in their own rights in every way.
Hello.
Unfortunately, Rwandan Adrian Niyashuti didn't make it. The blood clot put him too far behind the others in his team.
Nubwo ntarimo ariko barampagarariye, bahagarariye njyewe, bahagarariye n'abandi ba.
Abayitereyese nubwo baracyagutsinda.
Mukuri byarangoye kugaruka mu igare nyuma y'igihe gisanga kirenze ku mezi 10 nari mpagaritse nta competition nyina.
South African Songizo Jim also wasn't selected.
This year I was close to achieving my dream, but I didn't, but I was close. So now I have to work really hard that next year I can achieve my dream.
But for Eritrean Daniel Taklahamanot, the dream did come true.
From South Africa, first African team in the Tour de France, MTN-Qhubeka.
Not only was this his first entry into the Tour de France, he made the impossible a reality.
There's history being made with Daniel Taklahamanot, the first Eritrean to roll down the ramp, riding for MTN-Qhubeka.
Taklahamanot breaks. There is no reaction. They've realised what is happening. It's 1 point, and we have our first African king of the mountains of the Tour de France.
A huge achievement, despite his visa problems and the year of racing he missed.
Well, sometimes you see dreams do come true in the Tour de France.
Well, what a beautiful moment that is. Daniel Taklahamanot from Eritrea, the first African to wear a jersey at the Tour de France.
When I was young, I was really excited to be wearing this jersey.
It's real. I can't believe it. I think today I was really make some history, I think.
A history that's just beginning. The African team have dreams that are even more bold and ambitious.
If we can develop that hero, that African hero on a bicycle that started on a Qhubeka Buffalo bicycle to the Tour de France, that will be the cradle to the Holy Grail for this team and for cycling across Africa.